Utility companies are installing smart meters like this Landis and Gyr AXR-SD meter on residences around the country. The smart meters in my Sacramento neighborhood alone generate over 200 watts total RF power on 902 to 928 MHz. Considering that the Sacramento Metropolitan Utility District, SMUD, has installed over 600,000 of these meters in the Sacramento metropolitan area, over half a megawatt of random and licensed transmitters are causing interference throughout the 33 centimeters band in this community alone. VE3NCQ has posted an excellent description of the smart meter interference problem in Canada, and how the energy industry has in effect illegally appropriated the 902 to 928 MHz band with no regard for rendering it useless for licensed amateur radio operations in metropolitan areas. As described on the ARRL website, these smart meters are unlicensed FCC Part 15 devices, not ISM devices. As such, they have no protection from interference from licensed users of 902 to 928 MHz and must not cause interference to licensed spectrum users, that is, to either primary ISM or to the secondary amateur radio service. According to FCC Part 15 regulations, it is the responsibility of the user, SMUD, to mitigate harmful interference caused by these unlicensed devices to amateur stations and other licensed users of these frequencies. Here is the FCC ID label on the transmitter inside these smart meters that stipulates that it can only legally operate if it does not cause harmful interference. This FCC ID information is Grantee Code, OWS Product Code, NIC 514. This is an illustration of the 3 decibel gain WP wireless under glass mount antenna that is attached to the 1 watt transmitter inside each Landis and Gyr Focus AXR-SD smart meter. Here is a photo of a typical smart meter neighborhood area concentrator at 902 MHz input. This particular concentrator can link up to 1024 smart meters. It uses 902 MHz as the aggregated output backhaul to the network operations center, NOC, or another upstream concentrator before the NOC. Here are photos of the smart meter concentrator that is located atop a light pole 150 meters from my home. The signals from neighbors' smart meters were received quite strongly on this 4-inch flexible antenna in a ground floor window with the nearest smart meter about 20 feet away across this driveway, and many other neighbors' meters nearby. The signals vary in strength, as expected from meters at varying distances. They match the characteristics of the FCC test reports for the Landis and Gyr Focus AXR-SD smart meters. They resemble the signals in W60TW's video spectrum analysis of a smart meter, and as described by VE3NCQ and in other references. The FCC emissions test report shows the Focus AXR-SD smart meter signal bandwidth is 206 kHz at 915.3 MHz. The on time for each pulse is 83 milliseconds. At a given frequency there is one pulse in 20 seconds. The emission designator is 224 KF1D. The maximum 99% bandwidth is 224.5 kHz. The smart meter antenna gain is 4 decibels and the effective radiated power is 1 watt, 29.86 dBm. The FCC emissions test report shows the Focus AXR-SD smart meter frequency hopping every 300 kHz starting at 902.3 MHz. The FCC emissions test report shows the Focus AXR-SD smart meter frequency hopping through 83 channels, every 300 kHz from 902.3 MHz through 926.9 MHz. FCC Part 15 rules were intended to allow sporadic operation of individual low-power transmitters without causing interference. The blanketing of metropolitan areas with networks of autonomous Part 15 transmitters creates an uncontrollable source of constant interference to licensed users that violates the terms and spirit of Part 15 rules. These unlicensed 33 cm transmitters have continued to proliferate at a rate that surpasses anything previously there by several orders of magnitude. The longer we delay in demanding enforcement of FCC rules that protect us from the interference from this growing encroachment on our 33 cm band, the more the utility companies will continue to flood our neighborhoods and cities with multiple thousands of 1 watt Part 15 transmitters on this band and thus render it useless for licensed users.